In this video, we'll show you how to use one of the most exciting things in the Dante toolbox, Dante Virtual Soundcard. Dante Virtual Soundcard is software that allows you to record or play out up to 64 channels of pristine network audio directly from your Mac or PC with no additional hardware attached. Dante Virtual Soundcard is software that turns any Mac or Windows PC into a Dante audio device instantly. You can use any of your favorite audio applications with Dante Virtual Soundcard. DAWs like Logic, Pro Tools and Cubase, performance tools like Reason, and consumer apps such as iTunes. Dante Virtual Soundcard packs the full power of a 64-channel sound card into a laptop, allowing you to obtain professional results wherever you need it to be. The Dante Virtual Soundcard application is really a control panel for the drivers that connect audio to the Dante network. You can start and stop these drivers by clicking Start or Stop in the Virtual Soundcard application. Note that once Dante Virtual Soundcard is started, you can close the application itself. The drivers continue to be available, even between reboots, until you open Dante Virtual Soundcard again and stop them. Once Dante Virtual Soundcard is started, we can select it as an audio device in our applications. Once running, Dante Virtual Soundcard appears in Dante Controller just like any other Dante device, ready to send and receive audio. If we stop Dante Virtual Soundcard, it disappears from Dante Controller and no longer appears as an audio device on our computer. A special note for Windows users. On Windows computers, Dante Virtual Soundcard allows you to choose between two different types of drivers. ASIO drivers are the type most often used by professional-level, multi-channel audio applications. ASIO audio channels do not appear in the Windows Sound Control Panel, but are selected within supported applications. WDM drivers are the type commonly associated with Windows audio devices and are used by consumer audio applications. Dante Virtual Soundcard WDM channels appear as stereo pairs in the Windows Sound Control Panel. When ASIO drivers are selected, WDM drivers will appear grayed out in the Windows Sound Control Panel. In general, use ASIO for high-performance, low-latency recording with multi-channel applications such as Nuendo or Pro Tools. Use WDM to capture audio from consumer applications such as iTunes, VLC, or Windows Media Player. Dante Virtual Soundcard allows you to set parameters to suit your needs. To make adjustments to Dante Virtual Soundcard, you must first stop it from being active by clicking the Stop button. We can set the number of channels that Dante Virtual Soundcard uses with the Audio Channels dropdown, from 2x2 up to 64x64. Choose the lowest number that fits your project in order to conserve your computer's resources. We can adjust latency to be 4, 6, or 10 milliseconds. This is the delay between signal transmission on the network and reception by an application on your computer. Lower values of latency place a greater load upon your computer's CPU, so choose the highest value you can use in order to decrease the chances of clicks and pops. Low latency is only required at times when one is listening to playout simultaneously with other sources, such as overdubbing or using in-ear monitors. If you are only capturing audio, use the highest value of 10 milliseconds for consistently good results. The network interface dropdown allows you to select among available physical network connections on your computer. Because most modern computers have both Ethernet and Wi-Fi, multiple interfaces may appear. Choose the one that corresponds to the wired Ethernet jack you wish to use. Finally, Dante Virtual Soundcard supports multiple sample rates. These are accessed in the device view of Dante Controller, exactly as with Dante hardware interfaces. Let's illustrate this by doing some simple recording. For a source, we've set up an 8-channel multitrack recording coming from this Yamaha LS9 mixing console. All 8 channels are assigned to Dante transmit channels on the LS9. We've got the Dante MY16 card in the LS9 connected to this network switch, as is the Ethernet port on this MacBook. Let's check Dante Virtual Soundcard and make sure that we have enough channels exposed. We do, and so let's start Dante Virtual Soundcard. In Dante Controller, we'll assign all 8 channels of our mixer to Dante Virtual Soundcard. Now we open Logic with a new project. In Audio Preferences, we see that Dante Virtual Soundcard is available as both a source and a destination. We'll choose these channels as our source and assign them to tracks, just as we would with any other audio interface we might use. Now, let's start playback of our music source into the LS9 and verify that there's a signal there. We go back to Logic and hit Record, and there's our audio coming in on all tracks. Let's allow it to record for a few seconds. Okay, now we'll stop the original audio source and play out the tracks we just recorded. To do this, we'll use Dante Virtual Soundcard again, this time sending a two-channel mix to our speakers. So, I subscribe the two receiving channels of this speaker to transmit channels 1 and 2 of Dante Virtual Soundcard. In Logic, we assign channels 1 and 2 of Dante Virtual Soundcard to our stereo output. Hit play, and there we are. We can adjust levels and verify that it all really works. We hope you found this video about Dante Virtual Soundcard helpful. Be sure to watch all the videos in this series, and you'll be a Dante expert in no time.